right, we're back with the iFLYTEK Smart Translator. That's right, we took a look at the Smart Recorder just a little bit ago, and now we're going to be taking a look at the actual Smart Translator. This device is going to be a little bit different because it allows for real-time, bilingual, face-to-face translation offline, right? And if you have, you know, anything that you need to look at, like a sign or a menu or something, it's also got a camera built into it, so you can also do translation up to 50 languages using the camera. I believe you can do 60 languages total if you're using online Wi-Fi hotspot, or even the built-in 2 years worth of data that it has for over 200 countries. Finally, another piece of AI technology that I'm super excited about, not just because it's something that I will really genuinely use in my life, but because it actually works without a subscription. Again, the iFLYTEK devices are something I really enjoy because they use algorithms and actual processing power to get done a lot of the jobs that many other people are doing only on the cloud and only with subscription models. Experience the true simultaneous speech translations with iFLYTEK exclusive face-to-face translation supporting 19 common languages, perfect for business cooperation and academic exchange. So what they're talking about right there is there's 19 languages built into it that don't need to use any internet or of any kind, right? Those are going to be common languages. And if you didn't get a chance to see iFLYTEK's other device, this was the Smart Recorder that I got from them. It's one of those things where all you have to do is just turn it on, and then as soon as you hit the record button, it starts to record right there. So we're going to go ahead, and as we're doing this, we're just going to go ahead and record this because this is going to give us a real-time transcription. So while it's transcribing, I can actually use this file later to just insert straight into ChatGPT. I can ask it questions about my video. I can have it help me as an editor. Really, I can use it for all kinds of different things. And this device right here is also not attached to any Wi-Fi. It's not attached to anything at all other than just it's doing all the computation, all the recording, all the transcription on it by itself. So the iFLYTEK devices are very, very useful when it comes to not having to have subscription services for things that are just necessary, right? Such as translation, transcription, recording, right? We need these basic functions. And again, I really, really do like my Plod Note, which does a lot of these things as well, but you do have to have a subscription service for this. And although it's a completely different product, it's something that these things are gonna be able to work for you in a completely different way and are great to have as part of your workflow. Free global data, as it says. Now it says over 148 countries and regions. So one little pointer here, we're gonna go ahead and mention this. It says over 148 countries right there. Over here it says more than 100 countries. Up here it says covering 200 countries and regions worldwide. iFLYTEK, I do like your products. Your products do work. You gotta get better at your messaging. We need consistent messaging. I don't know which one of these is true, right? I'm gonna have to take a look at the instructions on the inside and see what they say. I'm sure there's gonna be a number on there. So, leading Octa-Core CPU, harnessing the power of an Octa-Core CPU, the Smart Translator delivers unparalleled processing speed and efficiency. Customized hi-fi speaker, integrated noise-canceling algorithm, and a 2000 megahertz battery. That's good. That's actually really nice to see that it's got a big battery in there. So it's gonna be something I don't have to worry about charging every single day. I can actually just kind of keep it in my bag and walk around and it's gonna work for me when I need it. That's what that tells me. So let's go ahead and jump back to the main camera scene. Ooh. Okay, iFLYTEK. I like how it has kind of everything on here. Indicator light, loudspeaker up here on top, that hi-fi loudspeaker, the microphone array, microphone, two microphones. It's got the ability to put a SIM card in there, SIM card slot, power button, volume button. 2 year, no need to purchase additional data or insert SIM cards while traveling, simultaneously supporting Wi-Fi hotspot and other network connections. See, you can, but you don't have to, right? So it just has all these accessibility features, which I find to be amazing for people who are living in different countries, who have just different abilities to, you know, get data or have Wi-Fi, or depending on where you're going. Let's say you're running out in, you know, in places unknown, right? You're gonna wanna make sure to have a proper SIM card in there at that point. So let's go ahead and just hold down this power button right here and see if the screen turns on. And while this is turning on, we're gonna go ahead and open up the rest of these boxes just to see exactly what we got inside. So hold down the red button and say hello, then release to translate. Blue button, hold down the blue button and say hello, then release the button for translate. Okay, so it's depending on which language you're gonna be using, okay. Voice translation button free, voice translation button free, face-to-face translation, photo translation. That's all there really is. All right, Let's go ahead and look in the bottom of this guy real fast, and we can see we do have a USB-C cable in here, and that's it. That's it. We've got a volume button on there. We're gonna go ahead and turn that one up quite a bit, and English, continue. Thank you for choosing Smart Translator. We highly value your privacy and committed to ensuring security. Again, okay, so now it's gonna start checking for the Wi-Fi around me. Voice translation setting, gesture detection, pick up and speak. Place the top of the translator close to your mouth and speak, maximum active recognition distance. So in this one, it says, after the offline language is downloaded, a voice translation is available even without the internet. All right, so I can kind of choose which one of these I need to have, going either direction. English to USA, Russian to USA. Well, internet turns on. The moment you turn the device on, it starts the global internet. All right, records export. We can go into there, and it's actually, it tells you to plug it into your computer. If you plug it into your computer, then you can export it, whether it be Mac or your PC. Global network card, you've obtained free global traffic, free for 2 years, effective until 26. Okay, got it. All right, now we can go ahead and take some photos. We're gonna go ahead and just take a quick photo of the Chinese simplified right there. Just a quick little shot. Let's see what that does. There we go. Wow, that actually looks really good. Hello, I just bought a new translation device. Can you understand this message? I can. And then it allow. Oh, if I hit this, it'll actually read it for me.
你好，我刚买了一个新的翻译设备。你能理解这条消息吗？
Okay.
Hello, I just bought a new translation device. Can you understand this message?
And this one, let's go ahead and do some Italian. It'll check the Italian. Hi, I just bought a new translation device. Can you get the message? And it still translates even if it's not the right language up there. It's still going to do the best it can, I think. So to give access to use the mic. Hello, can you hear me right now? I want to try to translate this to French to see what it sounds like.
Bonjour, pouvez-vous m'entendre maintenant? Je veux essayer de traduire ceci en français pour voir à quoi cela ressemble.
Oui, oui, je m'appelle Jean-Claude. Comment t'appelles-tu en français?
Yes, yes, my name is Jean-Claude. What is your name in French?
My name in French is Jean-Claude. Are you feeling okay today?
Mon nom en français est John Imparfait. Tu te sens bien aujourd'hui?
Non, ça va. Je suis malade.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm sick. I'm sick.
I'm fine, I'm fine. I'm sick, I'm sick. Yeah, no. Okay, that's kind of funny. So let's go ahead and try face-to-face translation. So you tap to speak it. And how you doing right now? What's going on? Real-time transcription and translation.
Hey, comment vas-tu? Comment vas-tu en ce moment? Que se passe-t-il?
Ah oui, je suis fatigué.
Oh yes, I am tired.
All right. Nice. So yeah, it works for this real-time translation. So this is just a quick little test. We're going to have to actually go out and use this for real in some real-life situations. Luckily, I'm going to have some opportunities here with some students where I can actually test this out. We're going to do that then. If I touch the button right there, you can see it's able to actually hear everything I'm hearing. And again, the moment I stop talking for 3 seconds, it's going to stop. Then take those words and then put them into translation and then start to speak them. And as you can see, as I'm speaking, it's doing the real-time transcription, just as this device over here is still doing. 25 minutes now, it's been listening to me, and it's doing the best that it can by transcribing. So, all right, let's take a look.
Appuyez sur le bouton juste là, vous pouvez voir qu'il est capable de tout entendre. J'entends et encore au moment où j'arrête de parler pendant 3 secondes. Il va s'arrêter et prendre ses mots. Et
okay,
puis
okay,
traduire
okay.
Et ensuite commencer à les...
Okay, good job. It's working. Hello, how are you doing today? Are you enjoying the weather? Would you like anything to eat?
Привет, как дела сегодня? Наслаждаешься погодой или хочешь что-нибудь поесть?
Mm. Okay, so there's the first look at the translator. It has all the features that you would need in a translator. I can say there's a little bit of static sounding when the voice is coming out of the speaker. I think that's because it's trying to do the translations so quickly, and the actual transcription has that. I've noticed that artifact when I've used some other types of AI devices before. So I'm pretty sure that's something they can certainly clear up in future firmware updates. So again, the clarity and the sound of the actual voice when it comes out is something I'd like to see improved minorly, right? Just to get rid of some of those static sounds. If they could do that, it would just make my experience all the better. So this is just a really nice, simple device. If you're somebody who travels a lot, why wouldn't you have one of these devices on you just to make sure that you don't get lost, so that you don't misunderstand something or misunderstand someone, right? So these kinds of devices are truly something from the future, right? When I was a kid, I used to read sci-fi books that talked about devices just like this. Great. iFLYTEK, keep it coming. I love these devices. I'm going to keep checking them out. I'm going to keep reviewing them. Until then. Later. Bye.